Hello, Gemini. Welcome to your monthly love reading. This will be for Sun and Rising and Venus. Please keep in mind, energy can go vice versa, and this reading won't resonate with everyone, so take what fits and leave the rest out. Happy New Year's to you all. Many blessings to you guys as we start this new year. Okay, we have protection with movement. So something's not quite what it seems here. Something's been happening that you are unaware of, but it's due to concealing and protection purposes. Okay, so I do see that something has been brewing here. Okay, a plan's been set in place and someone's wanting to do something about it now. I want you, I regret lying to you. Yeah, so I see a facade. You know, someone putting some kind of a wall up, almost an illusion, okay? So something that you've not seen the truth on. So Five of Swords is the overall energy. This is about taking charge in your own decision-making, causing conflict, okay? Winning at all costs, no matter what. So someone's done something here, and at the cost of losing something else that's of importance. So let's see what's going on in your energy this month. Knight of Wands, Judgments, Eight of Cups. So this is like a reassessment period for you. You definitely are letting go of something that no longer serve your highest good. I do see in the Knight of Wands, you're taking charge of your life, taking charge of your emotions, staying very much in control of what you want to do and not allowing other people to affect you or try to take over, you know, things that, you know, you just feel are not quite right for you as well. Okay, so I do see this is a great start to the year where you're finally taking charge and you're making decisions that are benefiting your life greatly. So we have the Seven of Swords, Hermit, and the King of Pentacles for their energy. Yeah, they've been concealing things here, okay? With the Hermit, some of them have been gone for a very long time. With the King of Pentacles, they are definitely trying to get their life in order. And as they start to fix things in their environment or some circumstances that really happened to them in a negative way, so they fell on some hard times, especially financially here, but as they're getting that fixed, they're looking towards the future here and knowing that what their heart truly wants is to fix this connection as well, feeling like they have to finally do the right thing, okay? Turn with the Seven of Swords. Chariot, Five of Cups. So you have no idea that this person has been regretting a lot, but devastated being without you. They're missing you greatly, almost to the point where they feel like they can't stand it anymore. They're hitting rock bottom here. So let's see what's happened in the past. We have Queen of Cups, Ten of Cups, and the Magician. Okay. So in the beginning, this person could be very charming. They definitely were saying the right things, doing the right things, but it quickly turned in a different direction. It felt like they were more so just trying to tell you what you wanted to hear because they weren't really backing anything up with what they were saying. And I see that they were playing with your heartstrings here. They really do have this deep feeling for you. They care about you and also very much in love, Ten of Cups, Queen of Cups, but not wanting to focus on those feelings because they felt like they need to focus on something else that was more important. And I see it came at a cost here, okay, losing your respect as well as losing the attraction as well. But I see they made some rash decisions that were not beneficial to this connection. Because they were trying to really build their life. There was a fear here of losing security and other things that were going on. They felt like their life was in complete chaos. And they were unwilling to really let you know this. Some of you do know in the general sense, but there's a lot of little details here that were really something that they concealed, okay? They didn't want you to get involved or let you know, and they also didn't want you to look at them in a different light. Tell me the Queen of Cups, please. Two of Wands, they were definitely at a crossroads here, needing to make a decision because it looks like that They chose to sacrifice love, sacrifice their feelings, and completely diminish those to the point where, you know, financial gain or a job here, whatever they were focused on, was more important to them because they felt like that was their life source. Okay, so they were in this fear of losing, you know, everything that they had built. Tell me with the Two of Wands, please. Four of Cups. So they would reject you emotionally. They would not come around that often. At times, you know, you knew that they had kind of promised or they said they were going to be consistent here or stable, but then they never did, right? Everything that they said, it was never backed up by any truth. And so you felt like they were just playing with your heart, using you at times, keeping you around for their own gain. And I see with the Four of Wands, when they would return, you know, they would act like nothing was the matter, right? They would definitely not apologize, but also not really take your feelings into consideration. So it was always about them, right? I also see some of them played a game, playing the game as if they don't understand or they don't know any better, acting aloof, basically. And so they would just shrug off your feelings or emotions, or I see for some a little gaslighting, you know, as if you're crazy for feeling that, you know how I feel about you, and you know my life's busy. Okay, things like that. Six of Cups, Queen of Wands, and the Five of Pentacles for the challenge. So I see for a lot of them, there is a loss financially. Feeling like, you know, you are at a point in your life where you're very stable, you're doing great for yourself, and they feel like they had hit rock bottom, as if something was pulled underneath them. They felt like they were less than, and they felt like they did not want you to know that they were in that position and how bad it was, because you would look at them in a negative light or look down upon them, because they're seeing you as the Queen of Wands, and they were looking at you as an intimidation factor, and they were wanting you to think very highly of them, not look down upon them here. So they felt this deep love for you, but afraid to go after it. But they didn't want you to see some things that they were quite embarrassed about as well. Tell me the Five of Pentacles. Star Empress. Yeah, not only do they see you as their wish fulfillment here, but they feel like, you know, they're less than, in a sense, that you have everything going for you and they don't, okay? So something's really happened to them in their life at this point. You've gotten this connection with them where they felt like they had to put on this facade and it all had to be a fantasy at this point. They could not give into it in the 3D sense. So tell me about the Six of Cups, please. Ten of Swords. Because there are some haunting memories. Instead of being honest, they really felt like, you know, they've had to hide some things in their life, because when they do share or they are vulnerable and open up, that they're looked at in a way that's very negative and it's been hurtful to them. So they don't like to really bear all unless they are in this confident place and they feel successful and feel good about themselves. So that's, I see in the current moment, the realization here in the Hermit, understanding, you know, no, they need to be a stable force. They need to fix things in the King of Pentacles. And to do that, it means that they have to deal with some really hard conversations and hard truth, okay? So what they're about to do, we have Eight of Wands, Page of Swords, and the Emperor card. So we have a surprise coming, Eight of Wands, right? Things are moving fast and something's coming out of the blue. And it's about this person taking charge and finally revealing, but also giving you what you desire. So if this reading is resonating with you in the extended, we're going to go over exactly what action they take, what they're going to say moving forward, as well as the timing and the outcome. If this is your last stop, thank you so much for joining me. I love you guys and I'll see you next time.